Detective Carnby. God, I'm glad to see you. I was afraid you had left.
Me? You're the one who just disappeared.
It's hard to explain. I think I blacked out. It was like I went somewhere else.
It's okay, miss. You're clearly upset.
No, it's... I don't know what's happening.
This is a very stressful situation for you, I understand.
Ugh, no, you don't understand.
Just take a deep breath. Why don't you sit down, smoke some of the perique? If you want, I could even drive you back to New Orleans. I just want to have a talk with Dr. Gray first.
I want to stay. I found a talisman just like the one in the painting. I think I might be able to figure out where Tarawea is, where Jeremy wanted to go.
That's great. Just stay out of trouble, okay? Let me handle the investigation.
I'm not crazy, Detective. Not yet.
Okay, catch you later.
If a talisman like this can open up doors between the French Quarter and Derceto, then maybe Jeremy is hiding in some strange other world. Like Tarawea, the place he mentioned in the book. No matter where he is, it's clear that my search won't be limited to Derceto. I need the key.
Saw your notice in the boiler room. You should know Mr. Chance won't be coming back.
Paul, you're right about the plates on the boiler and the clock. They have been sabotaged, and I think I know who did it.
Dr. Elmore Lee Gray is Decetto's chief doctor. Accounting and all administrative work.
Looks sturdy. Doubt I'll be opening this. I need the key. I need the key.
Despite making a fool of herself in front of Dr. Gray and Detective Carnby, Emily felt surprisingly invigorated. She felt...
I need the key.
Good evening, Miss Hartwood. That is your name, isn't it? I would be terribly embarrassed if it wasn't.
You're right. Emily Hartwood, Jeremy's niece. Nice to meet you.
Ruth. Ruth Talon. You're smoking? How terribly quaint.
Maybe so, but I like it.
Would you care to share some? That smell is making me feel very nostalgic.
Is it all that you hope for?
I enjoy your light mockery, Miss Hartwood. I can tell we would make great friends.
How flattering. Too bad you're locked up in this place.
Your insincerity is really refreshing. I wish you were mad as I am, then you could stay.
Give it a few years and I might just be. Lunacy is one of my family's few privileges.
Oh, good. I'll be looking forward to it.
You don't know anything about what happened to Jeremy, do you?
Everyone here is really strange, and it's hard to know what to make of anything you hear. Occasionally, it sounds quite exciting, though. Good versus evil and all that. I'm sorry, but I don't think I have anything useful to share.
It doesn't matter. Thank you for the much-needed break.
Bon voyage.
Lost Plantations of Louisiana, Thierry Bricklow, 1917. Derceto was a small plantation on the eastern shore of Lake Pontchartrain.
Hmm.
What are you doing sneaking around? You almost scared me to death.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to disturb your ritual. I wouldn't have guessed voodoo was in practice at a place like this.
The doctor may be all about science, but I know these roots have power.
Do you know what's going on here? I have a feeling Derceto is cursed.
There are several players with stakes in this game. Derceto isn't cursed or blessed. It's a battleground. And it would all be a lot better if you could get your uncle out sooner than later.
That's all I'm trying to do.
I wish you the best of luck, Miss Hartwood. I really mean that. Now, if you'll excuse me, I need to look after my gumbo.
What's this? What's that? Huh. What's that stain? Looks like some...
You know, Mr. Waits, I saw a piece of the plate that
I brought. It's another one of those plates for the talisman. It's also broken and missing some pieces. sweat shut. I need the key. This must be the clock mentioned in the commonplace book. There's something missing. I need the key. Jeremy's room. All back to normal.
Is here. What a strange but beautiful room. The Astarte Artist Colony, I'm pretty sure they had a Mardi Gras crew called the Pirates of Pontchartrain when I was a child.
Well, I need to remember how to get them out again. They are locked up.
What a strange design.
I did it. I crossed the thresholds to my...
There's some aggressive-looking rot on these paintings. Did it break? The clock just stopped. Showing me something. That's just the hallway outside Jeremy's room, isn't it? Did it. I opened up another dream.
May 1923, Monday. All okay, ready for delivery. Maintenance, oil pump must be serviced. Any tampering causes large spills unless properly forestalled. Tuesday, shipment delayed but delivered. Maintenance.
Huh. I need the key.
Thank you.
There's something missing. There we go. I can break this. I just need something to hit it with.
Thank you.
Don't look down, Emily. Jeremy, you dropped your...
Mrs. Marcus?
Get off of me!
What are you doing here?
Trying to find my uncle.
Jeremy is your uncle?
Could you please? Thank you. And it's Miss Hartwood.
You don't remember me?
I remember you, Mr. Bois. I met your brother, Batiste, earlier.
I suppose he hadn't found Jeremy either then. We spread out to find him.
Can I have this? I'm trying to get to Tarawea.
Fine, believe the rest. I just want Jeremy to come looking. We have to leave before it comes inside.
What? Where?
Come quick!
Oh, God damn my soul.
The dream of the grave under the chenier suddenly vanished, and Emily found herself back at Derceto. Instead of Jeremy, she found Lottie, who, just like her brother Batiste, reminded her of John, who died.
Reflections on the power of the verb in certain texts. by Juan Luis Jorge. To act is in itself divine. Even the slightest movement of our hand is evidence of our soul in motion.
The Barlow Lens. Instructions.
What's this? Guess this works too.
Oh.
There was a dead body in here. Did I just imagine that? What's that stain? Looks like some kind of... rot.
Do you teach piano as well?
Huh?
You're a governess. Did you teach those clawing casino kids how to play the piano?
How do you know about that?
Just because grown-ups don't notice children doesn't mean we don't notice you.
Yes. I taught them some piano.
Are you any good at it?
Not good enough to play a broken one.
It fell from the attic. Brought half the ceiling down.
It was Jeremy's fault, wasn't it?
Nobody knows what happened, but you're not wrong.
Doing?
Mm. I'm gonna go now. See you around.
Ugh. There's more of that unsettling
on the common place of evil.
Come on, Grace. I'm too tired for games. I'll even let you play with my jackknife. Oh, good evening. You haven't seen a little girl by any chance, have you?
I don't think so.
You would have known if you did. The only kid crazy enough to be in this place.
She's not in her room, then?
That would be a first. Always running around causing trouble. She's very hard to pin down, that one. You want a sip?
I'm good, thank you.
Well, I should be going then. Unless there's anything you need from me.
I just want to find my uncle before anything happens to him.
Oh, don't worry, miss. He'll show up. He is much too lily-livered to kill himself.
Why would he?
It's his greatest ambition, didn't you know? Take care now.
McCarthy moseyed off to continue his search for the little girl. Emily had meant to ask why he was looking for her, but decided...
There's something missing. So this is Grace's room. Cute.
Don't you worry, Grace. Go play your game.
I think I've seen this somewhere. This must be the great Cassandra Beauregard's. I'm not sure what I expect. Maybe something more.
Miss Beauregard, I picked up your medicine at the post office.
Drive again? What's that? I need something else. I'm not sure I have everything I need. I need the key. Let's write this down. talisman is showing another wound. Something is open. I'm in another one of Jeremy's dreams. While since I visited the family tomb, I hope it's in a better state than the real world. There's something missing. What's this? There we go. This is the chapel in Jeremy's book. It looks like I need more medallions to open it. I'm not sure I have everything I need. Locked. Thank you. There we go. I made it out.
Emily, is that you?
Jeremy.
What are you doing here?
Well, you sounded so miserable in your letter. I've come to take you away from here.
I can't believe I made such a foolish mistake. All I wanted was for you to stay away.
What do you mean?
I bargained with the Dark Man. A pact to keep New Orleans safe with my own life as tribute.
The Dark Man isn't real, Jeremy. There is nothing he can do to hurt you.
How do you think any of this is happening? How do you still not trust my words?
Fine. Then let me help.
Don't be foolish. He will bury you next to me in his sunken temple for an eternity.
I don't care. I'll find a way. I have my own talisman, and I know about Tarawea.
Oh, wait. Don't speak.
Who's in here? Show yourself.
You know who, Emily. He took your grandfather.
No, I mean it. Who's in here? I can feel someone's in here.
Emily!
Tarawea. Why do you want to go there, Jeremy?
I've seen so many strange occurrences lately.
I need to find out more about Jeremy's pact with the Dark Man. He meant to go to Tarawea. Maybe there is something there that would help. She was beautiful. I wonder what happened to her. It's a telescope lens. Well, why would he lock it in here?
Jeremy had found...
Thank you.
what's going on? It's entering the numbers by itself? Okay, great, so where is that?
Was this dream of Tarawea without a catch? A place?
Now what? Here we go.